we've just, you know, been waiting for, and we're just so happy for you. Andrew is wonderful, and you just couldn't have found a better guy. You're so perfectly suited for each other. So I want to toast and wish you 1,000 years of wonderful, blissful marriage. Always be boyfriend and girlfriend. After your 100 kids, still be boyfriend and girlfriend. And here's to a wonderful day. Let's just all have fun. Aww. Right?
Here's to everybody touching up their eye makeup.
And then seeing your parents as their role model, as your role model, you were following right in my footsteps, and I'm just so happy for you, and I love you so much.
Oh. All those little girl fights.
You can't talk.
All those little fights.
Yeah.
She's not even at the front yet, she's crying.
We're gonna stop with the shakes.
Don't let
her. We're gonna stop when she shakes.
Andrew, I can't thank you enough for all you've done for me these past years. You are my rock and my favorite person. You make me whole. I've dreamed of giving this cologne to my future husband. I can't believe I found someone as great as you. Love you now and always, Bethany.
What is it?
It's a monogrammed Yeti Cody. Cozy. Does Adam on it?
Thanks, buddy. Beautiful.
Thank you. You look amazing.
Glad to see you.
You
nervous? You nervous?
Yeah, I'm nervous.
You look beautiful.
Thank you.
Excited?
Yeah.
Good. You want to see the gift?
Nervous. Yeah. Sorry, I'm just like.
This is for me.
Thank you.
We should move back. This is for me.
Mm-hmm. There's a card in there.
There you go.
Oh, of course. Star Wars. Oh, that's so sweet.
Thank you. Is that it?
Yeah. Right, yeah.
It's ready to get this started?
Yeah, I know. I'm like shaking. I don't know what's wrong with me.
I don't know why. Supposed to be a map of where we proposed.
Oh, it's beautiful.
I'm looking down. I can see down.
I'm not peeking.
I'm sorry.
I'm not peeking.
He's looking down, though. He's looking down. He won't peek.
Oh, no. I didn't polish my shoes. Do I get to hug?
That's beautiful.
All of us have been here for the last 6 hours and we're dying.
Love you so much, Beth. So proud of you. So proud of you.
Love you. Love you.
Don't God, get her. Bethany. Don't get her crying.
Oh, okay.
So
I know.
We're back.
Yeah, the youngest one looks so stoked to be doing this right now. And the mama.
I got a boat.
Let me grab your bar.
If you want to see your dad, stand up there. There you go.
Yeah, let's get those.
Right there. That's a boy.
Bethany.
You look absolutely gorgeous. Doesn't she, everybody?
Yeah.
God has ordained and blessed that he would bring this woman. He'd bring her to you that this day you would wed. You'd become one. That is a miracle that only God can preside over. And as Adam saw the woman, Eve, he said, "This is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh." What he was saying is, this is someone I can relate to, a helpmate, a companion. In other words, he was saying, this is someone who completes me. And so the word of God says, for this reason, a man shall cleave to his father, he shall leave his father and mother and shall cleave to his wife, and the two shall become one. And so, Andrew, do you take this woman to be your lawfully wedded wife? Do you promise to love, honor, and cherish her, so help you God?
I do.
And Bethany, do you take this man to be your lawfully wedded husband? Do you promise to cherish, honor, and love him, so help you God?
I do.
Amen. So understanding that, we recognize, and the reason why I turn to the Word of God is because marriage is God's institution. It's his design. It's something that he set up. And so, in a sense, he's ordained this, he's planned this, and he's now presiding over this moment. And I want to take a moment to read from Scripture to give us bearings in regards to what a marriage should look like. And in Ephesians 5, the Apostle Paul says, out of respect for Christ, be courteous and reverent towards one another. Wives, understand and support your husbands in ways to show your support for Christ. And the husband provides leadership for his wife the way Christ does his church, not by domineering, but by cherishing. So just as the church submits to Christ as he exercised such leadership, wives should likewise submit to their husbands, and husbands, go all out in love for your wives, exactly as Christ has for the church. A love marked by giving, not getting. Christ's love makes the church whole, and his words invoke her beauty. And everything he does and says is designed to bring out the best, dressing her in dazzling white silk, radiant with holiness. And that is how a husband ought to love his wife. They're really doing themselves a favor since they're one in marriage. The Apostle Paul goes on to say, no one abuses his own body. No, he feeds and pampers it. That is how Christ treats us, the church, since we are part of his body. And this is how a man loves his wife. And so he is to leave his mother and father and cherish his wife, no longer two, but now becoming one in flesh. And he goes on to say, this is a huge mystery. One I do not pretend to understand all, but what is clearest to me is the way Christ treats the church. And that is how a man is supposed to treat and love his wife. And as I met with Bethany and Andrew, we talked about the significance of understanding God's perfect law, his word. See, it's his design, it's his institution, so we look to his word. And so understanding that this is a moment where he is now making these two become one. That is precious. And that is something they understand, and that is something that they are willing to submit to. I take you as a gift from God.
to be my lawfully wedded wife.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
In good times.
In good times.
In bad times.
In bad times.
In sickness.
In sickness.
And in health.
And in health.
For richer.
For richer.
For poorer. For
poorer.
And forsaking all others.
And forsaking all others.
I give myself wholly to you.
I give myself wholly to you.
I, Bethany.
I, Bethany.
Vow to love you, Andrew.
Vow to love you, Andrew.
As unto the Lord.
As unto the Lord.
I take you as a gift from God.
I take you as a gift from God.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
In good times.
In good times.
In bad times.
In bad times.
In sickness.
In sickness.
And in health.
And in health.
For richer.
For richer.
For poorer.
For poorer.
And forsaking all others.
And forsaking all others.
I give myself wholly to you.
I give myself wholly to you.
Amen.
Amen.
These vows now you seal with rings. So. So Andrew, repeat after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
Good job. Other hand. And Bethany, repeat after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
She did a little better job.
Mm-hmm. Of course.
Not that anybody's taking account there.
Bethany, when we first met, I wasn't looking for love. It had been a long journey for me to get back to a safe place in my heart and in my mind to love again. Like an angel, you dropped from heaven down to me. And I love you with every fiber of my body. I promise to always be true to you and the same, and not always on the same team. I will do my best to try and stay positive and everything, and then be everything you always wanted to be. I love you with all my heart, and I can't wait for us to be married.
Andrew, from the moment I met you, I knew you were someone special. You came into my life at truly the perfect time. I was beginning to lose hope in finding a good support system in LA, and it is so tough to navigate such a crazy city without a family nearby me. When we met, it was so easy to spend time with you. I now have the support system I've always longed for, to watch how great of a father you are to Hayden and Nixon is only a reminder of how I am so glad to have them as part of my family. I truly cannot wait to watch them grow up into great men like their father. True love with you is simple as just spending time next to your side. I truly can't wait to experience the many adventures of life ahead of us. Andrew, you are my rock. You are my soulmate. You are my everything. I love you so much. And I'm so honored to spend the rest of my life with you by my side.
As you exchange vows, I want to simply remind you of that last moment we had on my porch, where I kind of wrapped up everything we had talked about, everything you read about in regards to marriage. One thing that I know is true. Love needs to exist here. The Bible clearly gives an example that Jesus is love. And in Him you will find infinite well. The times that are hard, the times that are difficult, the times that are wonderful, you will find an infinite well and an infinite resource of love found in the person of Jesus Christ. And so I want to remind you of that. All that is needed, all that is required for this marriage to be fruitful, not perfect, but fruitful, will be found in Him, Christ Jesus. And so with that in mind, I want you to know that I have great confidence that you too, as you've become one, will be a great resource to the kingdom and to your community. And so by the power vested in me, by the Lord Jesus Christ and the great state of California, I pronounce you husband and wife. Andrew, you may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my great honor and privilege to pronounce to you for the very first time, husband and wife, here they are, Bethany and Andrew.
Got that done.
Yeah.
Oof. I was sweating those vows, man.
Me too. You were just way short.
I told you. I told you. And if there is no more time, it's always a man. If the anthem fails to step apart. Because I remember the day I waited so patiently for God to bring someone who's going to be good to me.
Friend of mine, his name is Jim. Jim's sitting over there, and he had two daughters married. And I said, Jim, what do I do? I've never had a daughter married. And he goes, shut up and write the checks. I didn't do extremely well in that effect. But this is my time, and I'm going to take as much as I can. I'm going to milk this, actually. the pastor, who did a great job. Am I wrong? He did a great job. Pastor G. He asked me, kind of a Christian comment, he said, Ernie, how do you know there's a God? I said, wow, that's a hard comment. But I had one word. I said, Bethany. He goes, wow, how do you know that? I said, well, we had three boys, and one was Adam. And Bethany was our fourth child, and Colleen and I needed a break. And God love her. I mean, Bethany, all of you know this about her. She's beautiful. She's calm. She's laid back. She cares about other people. And she's mellow. And we needed that, really, after three boys. In fact, we were pooped, Mom and I. True story, Beth. I don't know how old we were, Colleen, at the time we had Bethany. In our 50s or 60s. I'm not sure. So we were kind of checked out, but we were so happy that Bethany was pretty mellow. And so I have to tell you that by the age of 9, Bethany had no curfew. She had no curfew. By 14, she was driving. And as Rick, our other friend, knows, she was pretty much hitting anything. She never met a mailbox she didn't like. By 16, she had a total wine credit card. We didn't know. I mean, really, we were spent. But on a serious note, my nickname for Bethany was girlfriend. And at first, Bethany thought, that's kind of odd, Dad. It makes me feel weird. I said, no, you're my best friend, and you're a girl. You're my girlfriend. And so I was always in fashion. And so Bethany was always interested in that. So on Sundays, we would go out and we would walk the malls and she would tell me, we called it checking the competition, what was really cool. Dad, you guys should have this or you should have that. And we really kind of bonded that and among other things. So then Bethany goes off to college and she majors in fashion merchandising. And then she ends up in LA where she meets the Passport crew. Where are you guys? Sanjeev and his team, and they've really treated her so well. Thank you guys so much. You're great. And so now she's in fashion. She's in L.A. And Colleen and I are thinking, how the heck are we going to get her back to St. Louis? And we thought we had a brief shot, and she met Andrew. And what a wonderful man he is. I mean this sincerely. What a match, right? Andrew is kind. He's enthusiastic. And he's laid back. He's what you would call an, he's an L.A. dude. So just to make this a little bit brief, if I can, I always tell my kids, when you marry, you get to family. And to the Jansen family, Tracy and Tim and everybody else, Bethany, you really got a great family. This is going to be really good. So I'm going to leave you with this one note for Bethany and Andrew, and then we'll toast. Three things. Colleen and I have been married well over 45 years. And the people ask, how the heck do you do that? And we say three things. Faith, family, and always remain boyfriend and girlfriend. And so, Andrew, I'm giving you my girlfriend. Toast to Bethany and Andrew. God bless your marriage.
For those of you who do not know me, my name's Riley Hickey. I'm Bethany's best friend, Colleen and Ernie's worst nightmare. I'm not sure why, though. I only paid Bethany to skip school 3 times a week. And if I was really lucky, she would let me hide in her trunk while she flashed a blank piece of paper, hoping we would make it past the high school security officer. 99% of the time, we got away with it. Except for that one time we rolled up to Colleen at a stop sign on Big Ben. Or maybe it was because I convinced Bethany to throw a party when Colleen and Ernie went out of town. Which I managed to throw up all over their brand new carpet, so sorry, Ernie, that wasn't iced tea. Your new white carpet. But we didn't spend all our teenage years giving Colleen and Ernie those gray hairs. I think Adam took care of that. Bethany and I did everything together, and I was lucky to be a part of the Schluter family events. Monday night dinners were always a treat, but every year I look forward to hanging out at the party cove with the Schluters, where we overindulge in Coronas and Jello shots. The first time Bethany mentioned Andrew, I didn't take it too seriously, but after a few months had gone by, I figured it was probably time I go to California to meet this guy. My first impression of Andrew was, this guy's amazing, but man, can he talk. Which is probably why him and Ernie get along so well. So don't get caught in a room with them together. Andrew has brought out something in Bethany I've never seen. He's taught her how to clean. But in all seriousness, Andrew is the definition of a true gentleman. Andrew loves and wants nothing but the best for Bethany, which is what every best friend hopes they find in a life partner, and Bethany has truly found hers. Bethany, we haven't lived in the same city or state since high school, but regardless of the miles between us, you are always going to be my best friend. I cherish the memories that we have shared together and we will share in the future. So I'm going to leave you guys with a quote from Dr. Seuss. Yes, Dr. Seuss. You know you're in love when you can't fall asleep because your reality is finally better than your dreams. So please raise your glasses in honor of Bethany and Andrew. I love you guys and congratulations.
I'm Andy, Andrew's best man. And a couple people here have asked me if I'm Andrew's brother. And no, I'm not. It would be cool if Andrew had a brother named Andrew. That would be awesome. And while I consider him as a brother to me, I just wanted to, you know, clear it up in case anyone's confused. I'm just his best friend, all right? And so for some context, like where me and Andrew come from is I've known him for 13 years. We met right after high school through some mutual friends. It was kind of happenstance, but we hit it off immediately, you know? Like we both had like an emo like swoop haircut right after high school. And we both like exclusively listened to pop punk, like Blink-182's, our favorite bands. Come on.
The format.
The format, yeah. And so, you know, as two guys with bad haircuts, bad musical taste, and who were not good at guitar at all, we of course decided to start a band together. And it was great, all right?
That one show was really good.
Yeah. Did we even do a show?
I didn't make it to that one.
The name was Captain Placeholder, because we're very clever. And our music was non-existent. Like, what, did we ever even write a whole song? No. But we had a lot of fun, you know, playing loud, bad music in a garage together for a couple years. And then, you know, like, it's in the last 13 years, unfortunately, life and jobs took us away from the garage band. And I got to, you know, watch Andrew become a father, which was like a very, you know, scary, like, what does this mean kind of moment for me? But also, like, it's super impressive, like, watching Andrew step up and become a father, greatest, like, thing I've ever got to watch, right? Because I got to see this guy become, like, just a man, like, in front of me, like, responsible for things. Like, I would give him plenty of unsolicited advice that made no sense. And he would ignore it entirely. And it would take not a few months for me to look back and realize, like, oh, yeah, because Andrew is much smarter than me and better at this than I am. So, you know, we've been through a lot together, 13 years, hanging out. We moved 9 times total.
In like 5 years.
But yeah, in that 13 years, I did the math, and it's actually, I only moved you 3 times.
Yeah, I moved you.
6 times.
Exactly.
And Bethany was there 2 times.
Yeah.
And so that you know, that brings me to Bethany. We didn't meet, the first time we met was not when you helped move me, but I think that might have been the second time we met.
Yeah.
I remember there was 0 chance that I was going to like whoever Andrew was dating at the time. There was just no chance in the world that I was going to approve
of the girl that he was introducing me to. There was just nobody good enough for Andrew. But the first time I met you, you know, like, you had the best personality. Like, you were there. You're like, you just made it immediately clear. Like, I wasn't going to get to know you guys. Like, I like Andrew so much. Like, I want to know who you are. Who are you people? Was your attitude. And it was so amazing. And immediately, I remember driving home with Sam, my wife, thinking like, wow, she is so cool. Like, I'm so happy for Andrew. Like, I can't imagine, like, where this is going to go, but it seems really good. And so, you know, as we got to know each other, it became clear to me, you know, despite our bad taste in music, that Bethany has much better taste than you, Andrew. Yes. Definitely. That might be a Schluter thing. They have fine tastes. And that she cared about you. Like, and I have not seen you happier, Andrew, since you've met Bethany. And there's nothing that makes me happier than to see you happy. As like my best friend and just a man, like someone who like proved to me like what it takes, you know, to be a dad and to step up to the plate whenever they need to, and to like give me good advice about my relationship and just like as a person, like you be the best person. The way that Bethany augments that is incredible to me. So I guess cheers. I want to raise a glass to these two people being an incredible force together. And yeah, congratulations to Bethany and Andrew Jansen.
Thank you, Bethany.
We just want to say thank you guys so much for coming. You guys, like, it means the world that you flew out here, drove up here. It's not an easy, it's not right down the street, it's not close by. So the fact that you guys took the time to come to celebrate the best day of my life with me, it just means the world. So thank you guys all so much. I want to thank my parents. You guys have been the best, like the best. Like anything I wanted, you helped with everything. You guys have been my inspiration my whole life. 45 years marriage, and that's not easy to say. So you guys, yeah. And I just love you guys so much. I appreciate you guys. You guys are seriously the best, and I love you. And I want to thank Tim and Tracy. You guys are so great. You guys have helped out so much, so generous. You guys are my family in California, which is what I've always wanted. It means so much to have you guys. Hayden and Nixon, I love you guys so much. I'm so happy to have you as part of the family. And I love you all. Thank you. Want to say something?
Oh, I'm good.
You're good?
I'm good.
All
right. Yeah, thank you. Adam, you want to
I guess comments? Adam's going to give a speech now.
Wait, everyone stand back.
People might want to take a seat.
Wait, stand back.
I promise I don't want to, like I do, but I know that it's going to be emotional for me, so, and I truly am an introvert as much as people say that I'm not, but it doesn't matter, whatever, doesn't, none of this matters, okay, it's about you in this moment. Bethany, to me, is the reason that everything in my life is happening. Bethany is always been my silent rock. She has always been the girl that is silent, but always there with a word of encouragement. And I remember going to Mizzou, going to Columbia, and we have two older brothers, but they were a little bit farther apart from us and a little bit more mature than us and a little bit more conventional than us, right? And me and Bethany just bonded as just best friends because we were just a little bit different, but we were kind of going through some things in life together at the same time. And I was a big brother to her. And I remember going to Mizzou, and Bethany came for a year, and she didn't really want to come back the next year. It kind of scared her a little bit, and she did. And I remember, you know, L.A., and I'm going to LA, and I'm crazy. And Bethany is methodical and mature and logical. And so for Bethany to go to Mizzou, I knew how much it scared her to go back to Mizzou. That's incredible that you did that. And because of that, you have so many people in your life today, and you've become what you have. And then to go to LA by yourself, not really knowing anybody in that situation, is the reason that you met Andrew, and you're here in this situation. You left your comfort zone, you did this. And there's just so many moments of life that we got so close, and we really just, like, you were always there for me. But you were always there in my breakups, in my heartbreaks, in my difficulties, in my moments of life. And in every one of those times that you were there for me, in this back of my mind, I'm just saying, I want you to find that love that you deserve so much. And we grew so close through those years together. And we were such best friends. We're still best friends through this moment. And I was just, you have to understand, there's nobody that it would take something so much, someone so great, for me to respect enough to take your heart and take you to be your wife. And Andrew is that guy. And we got that in Andrew, and I didn't give it to him right away. I was so skeptical and so just, not for Andrew. It would have been anyone in that situation, anybody.
Because tougher than my dad right here.
Tougher than my dad. Bethany is my heart. She is my everything, and she is my best friend. And so to give that to somebody that, not to give that, but to almost like just kind of to trust someone with that intimacy with Bethany, Andrew has proved it countlessly. I am very intuitive. I'm very close to people. I love relationships. And I've given Andrew 100 times to prove that he was not genuine, or prove that he didn't have the best intentions, or prove that he was someone other than who he was coming off to be. And you never did that once. You're always a gentleman, and you're always the right person. And so we're so honored to have you, Andrew, and Bethany, I couldn't be happier for you. Love you so much, guys.
Thank you.
And ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause for all those wonderful toasts.
A voice that says I'll be here and you'll be all right. Thank you.
They're not ready.
Are y'all ready? I don't know. They might be ready. Are you guys ready? I'm on your side.
I said, well.
See, I told you. I told you they're ready. I got you guys. Don't worry.
I think he's ready. I don't know about that. Right there. They have the heater and everything.
Where's the blanket?
I said, well. You know you made me want to keep my heels up. Throw my hands up. Throw my head back up. Come on. Don't get to see you. Don't get to see you. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Y'all don't gotta go home. Where's it at the party?
Sideways In is at the party. So, man, we're going to come and join y'all and take some shots with y'all tonight.